UTAC trial is the first randomized trial in Caucasian population with alotinib, which has the aim to prove that in this population of patients also, giving a TKI in first line, if the mutation, activating mutation is present, is the best way to treat the patients. It has been shown through now five trials in Asian populations, one of them with erlotinib, the other one with gefitinib, but the Caucasian population still lacks this evidence. It's a requirement for regulatory authorities also to be sure that genetic differences we know about Caucasian and in Asian populations do not influence the results in a Caucasian population. Therefore, the idea was to build a trial which could show that potentially results could be superposable in two populations, and it was shown to be the case. Therefore, the key issue of UTAC trial is probably to say that Caucasian and Asian population are comparable to that sensitivity to treatment, and that TKI in first line should also be reimbursed and prescribed in EGFR mutated patients. This is a clinical consequence of the trial, and the takeoff message is probably now to wait for registration of the drugs, but mainly to try to standardize a systematic evaluation for EGFR mutation in adenocarcinoma with stage 4 disease. And if it's not in your institution, it should be done very close in Switzerland because it's available in most of the centers now. Optimal trial was the trial the same as UTAC, but it was performed in an Asian population and was also allow to prove a very striking difference between giving a TKI in first line in mutated patients as compared to classical chemotherapy. It was a hazard ratio of 0.16, so something completely different, but like I said before, in Asian population. We had at this ASCO, and it's very interesting because it's rare, we had the quality of life of this strategy, which also could demonstrate that apart from improving response rate, apart from improving PFS, you could also, in a very significant manner, improve quality of life of your patients when you adopt this kind of strategy. It was shown before in the IPASS trial. It's the only one from this trial with a quality of life assessment, but the difference was a bit less in the IPASS trial because they were not all mutated patients and the response was probably a bit different and a bit lower. Therefore, it's also an argument in more to not to forget to deliver TKI in first-line patients. We had also a Swiss trial, the STKK-1905 trial, which was designed before we had all this knowledge about EGFR mutations and the knowledge of some trials now which demonstrate that if in mutated patient EGFR is better in first line, in unmutated patient it is the contrary, you have to deliver chemotherapy. But at the moment of designing of 1905, it was not known, and the idea was to try in a phase 2 prospective trial, one arm, to deliver first bevacizumab and erlotinib to be able to deliver chemotherapy later and to induce toxicity later. It is important to note that one of the criteria to do this, to try this, is that the patient did not have to present a threatening disease, did not have to present the obligation to receive immediately chemotherapy, because this would not have been ethical. So using this strategy, this is an interesting poster because at the end of the game, it shows that the PFS and survival are really good. They are even comparable to the published data in which the other way around is done, like usually. There are two explanations of that. Maybe bevacizumab and erlotinib can be a bit better than erlotinib alone, and maybe allowing the patients to respond in a significant an interesting manner. And the other explanation is maybe that we have preselected some patients who could afford to have this strategy on board, and maybe not all of the patients can. So this is a phase 2. I think this strategy to deliver TKI in first line will be abandoned due to other result at ASCO this year, the innovation trial, which is negative. But this is interesting to show that some patients without mutation can really benefit to receive TKI plus or minus bevacizumab at one moment of their follow-up.